Hi guys, welcome to Auditor's Perspective. This is the continuing video of IBC 2018. The first video of IBC 2018 is given in the link of the video is given in description below, and I'm continuing with another few amendments of IBC 2018. The first amendment I'm going to discuss in this video is about MSME. What used to happen? I, being a promoter who has taken loans from banks, and I was not able to repay my loans. Now this bank has went to adjudicating authority, filing a resolution application against me. That is going to resolution, that is CIRP. Now the promoter and their related party used to bid for their own company and can get back to the position of promoters and again enjoy the promotership and carry on the company. But in as on November 2017, the government has came with an amendment saying that the promoter should not again bid for his own company and enjoy the promotership, because this promoter was the defaulter. This promoter could not able to carry the business. Why should we give the promoter another option? So on November 2017, in IBC, the government has made amendment and inserted a section 29A, which has many clauses restricting the promoters and other related parties, and types of disqualifications were discussed in that section. Now in this ordinance 2018, the government has given relief to few of the disqualifications given in section 29A. The first relief is the promoter whose account has been classified as NPA with a bank cannot able to file the resolution bid as per the amendment of November 2017. But in this ordinance, the government gave the green signal to the promoter whose account has been classified as NPA also. That is, the promoter, the defaulting promoter, can also bid for his company. The second clause, that is second amendment, of November 17 was the guarantor to the company was unable to file a bid for the company. But in this ordinance, in this ordinance 2018, the guarantor can also make an application. That is, make a bid for the company and enjoy promotership. See, why this amendment has come, guys? The MSME sector is the largest employment generating sector of the India, and seeing this, the government has thought that the promoters, these guys are running these companies, and the promoters should the genuine, the rightful promoter should get another option even when their account has been classified as NPA. So this amendment came, and now the promoters can, the NPA classified promoters can also bid, the guarantors can also bid for the company. And this is the first amendment, that is the MSME amendment of this video. Now the second amendment is regarding the home buyers. This is again an interesting amendment, where what used to happen, I, being a normal person, I give my money to a real estate player for supply of flats. The real estate player was unable to deliver the flat as on time. Now the home buyer do not have any authority where he can go. So they used to go to High Court and Supreme Courts, which take a long time to settle the case. Now the IBC ordinance, the IBC ordinance 2018 has given a boost to these home buyers, said that the home buyers will be classified as financial creditors. That is, the financial creditors, the home buyers can make an application against the real estate player to the adjudicating authority for CIRP, and they will also be the members of committee of creditors. And you guys know the work of committee of creditors. The committee of creditors in CIRP is the sole decision making authority. Okay, now by this amendment, the home buyers will decide the fate of the company. They have two options: either approve a resolution plan or disapprove, and then the company will go into liquidation. But there is an interesting interpretation which Sir Srinivas Injeti has stated, who is the secretary of MCA. He said that the home buyers are definitely financial creditors, but not the secured creditors, which boils down to interesting interpretation. That is, the home buyers, if approve the plan, approve a resolution bid, then the company will revive. The home buyers will take haircuts and will take flats or get the money from the new bidder. If they are unable to revive, if they don't agree with the bid, then the company will go into liquidation. But if the company will go into liquidation, these home buyers will not get any penny, because the home buyers are classified as unsecured creditors and not secured creditors. So it is very interesting to see whether the home buyers will make will be able to make the decision or not. And the industry experts express their view, saying that this is very difficult, because how an individual can assess whether this Tata or Aditya Birla Group or any other bidder application is correct for this company or not. So this will be very difficult going further. So this is the second amendment, that is, the home buyers has got financial creditor status. Now the third amendment is regarding the statutory time limits, where what used to happen, suppose I am company X, I am into CIRP, company Y has made a bid and the committee of creditors approved the bid. The Y is now the owner of this company, and the Y has to make payment to the financial creditors, and then it can start the company afresh. Okay, but the new company, that is company Y, has to take various statutory approvals for starting a company afresh. The major approval is from the CCI, that is Competition Commission of India, which oversees the competition in India. See, company Y is bidding. Why he will bid? He will bid for his inorganic growth. Now this Competition Commission of India will look into the matters give approval whether this is for the benefit of the public interest or not. So this particular approvals used to take a long time, very long time, and the bidder have to pour in money and wait for long time to start the company. In amendment 2018, the government says that the bidder will get 1 year or more, that is 1 year or the specified time limit as per the different act, whichever is more will be given to the bidder, and within that time the bidder will get the approvals and start the company. See, this amendment again is not very welcomed, because experts understand and says that for statutory approvals, you should give only 5 to 6 months, and 1 year and the amendment says or more is a very long time. Again, red tapeism in India is seen here. So this is the amendment where the statutory approvals earlier there was no time limits, now after the amendment there are time limits. So this is three other interesting amendments which I have discussed. There are other amendments, but that I have discussed only these amendments. Okay, but I have done a thing for you, that I have shared the link of Official Gazette in this description, also the blog which I wrote 3 months ago regarding these tweaks, and the link for the first video is also given in the description below. And that's it guys, I hope I have added value to your valuable time, and stay updated. Thank you.